Hello, my name is Stephanie Burrison. I'm a supervisory nurse research specialist with the Office of Research Support and Compliance. Today, I'll be giving you an overview of a research nurse coordinator. Some goals for this session is to define research nursing, understand the differences between a bedside nurse and a clinical research nurse, recognize the roles and responsibilities of a research nurse, and learn the different aliases for a research nurse. Clinical research nurses have many roles. I may not cover all the roles in this session, but just remember, clinical research nursing is one profession with many roles. So, what is a research nurse? A research nurse supports research by partnering with patients in support of their participation in clinical research. Research nurses implement and coordinate clinical research protocols and conduct independent and collaborative research. Clinical research nursing, understanding the differences. In addition to providing and coordinating clinical care, clinical research nurses have a central role in assuring patient safety, ongoing maintenance of informed consent, integrity of protocol procedures, and accuracy of research data collection. Clinical research nurses must continually balance the individual clinical needs of research participants and protocol requirements as they practice while assuring consistency of baseline treatment and monitoring across participants within a study. With clinical research nurses, you'll see clinical care for research subjects. It collaborates with research training and career development and all combined with nursing research. Some practice areas you may see clinical research nurses, inpatient outpatient units, such as med-surg, behavioral health, pediatrics, oncology, hematology, alcohol clinic, radiation oncology, ears, nose, and throat clinic, allergy and infectious disease clinic, clinical genetics and dermatology clinic, cardiology clinics and dental clinics, and some day hospitals such as pediatrics, med-surg, and hematology oncology. In 2007, nursing and patient care services at the NIH launched a 4-year strategic plan to lead an international effort to define the specialty practice of clinical research nursing. Clinical research nursing is nursing practice with a specialty focused on the care of research participants, developing tools to support the specialty practice of clinical research nursing. Documentation and clarification of the practice of clinical research nursing, and consensus around steps leading to possible national certification. Now, there are research organizations such as the International Association of Clinical Research Nurses, also known as IACRN, the Association of Clinical Research Professionals, known as ACRP, and the Society of Clinical Research Associates, also known as SOCRA, which offers continual education in research and certification exams to get certified in research. Here's a specialty practice domain where you'll see nurses contributing to science, clinical practice, human subjects protection, study management, care and coordination, and continuity of care. This is some scopes of clinical research nursing. Here is a clinical ladder where you'll see some nurses start with an undergraduate student, then they'll lead to a new grad, clinical research nurse, go up to a study coordinator or case manager, advanced practice nurse, where you'll see some nurse practitioners, pre-doctoral and doctoral students, post-doctoral training, and at the top, you'll see a clinical nurse scientist. These are the variety of roles you can see clinical research nurses in. Nurses in clinical research. As a clinical specialty, clinical research nursing incorporates the two main roles assumed by nurses practicing in clinical research settings. clinical research nurse, also known as a CRN, and a research nurse specialist, RNS. Some aliases for the research nurse specialist is research nurse coordinator, clinical trials nurse, study coordinator, clinical research nurse, clinical research coordinator, and clinical research care nurse. There are some study coordinators that are not research nurses. This presentation is specifically focusing on clinical research nurses. Nurses in clinical research. Just as investigators, nurses also balance the patient participant needs with the protocol requirements. Nurses in research have the responsibility of advocating for the patient so they are safe and their welfare is protected. Nurses spend the most time with patients, so it's critical that we share information with the participant and the study team to ensure their protections. Research nursing versus clinical research nurse, what's the difference? Research nurse coordinators may be initiator and or facilitator for the informed consent process, may provide indirect care to research participants, help with coordination and scheduling protocol-specific activities, help assure data collection specific to protocol requirements, and help with adverse event reporting and regulatory monitoring. Clinical research nurse may provide direct care to research participants, help with the protocol implementation, data collection, ensuring informed consent, implementation of protocol-specific procedures, and balance the individual clinical needs with protocol requirements. As you can see, both roles are very similar and some nurses may function in both roles. The primary responsibility of a research nurse is to coordinate daily activities of the trial, hands-on control of the trial. When it comes down to a research nurse, they're basically the PIs, the principal investigator's right hand. They have a huge responsibility to support their investigator, as you'll see in the next few slides. Some responsibilities of research nurses include coordinate study, recruiting, screening and scheduling patients, securing informed consent, study conduct, initiation, monitoring, and closeout visits, coordination of lab pickups and assist with lab supplies, maintain integrity of protocol, and maintain regulatory files. Also, they assist the principal investigator in preparing protocols and consent for initial review, continuing review, and amendments, help with timely submissions, help meet regulatory requirements, make sure the data is accurate, help with reporting adverse events, timely and complete. They help with maintaining participant records and documentation, including case report forms, clinical care, drug preparation and drug administration, and data management and quality assurance. Some other research nurse responsibilities include teaching patients and staff, help with the abstract, analyze and publish findings with the principal investigator. They stay informed with the principal investigator of new information regarding investigational agents. They help with the investigator's brochures, articles, help with safety reports and any memos, prepare and help facilitate monitoring of trials, and help resolve discrepancies, common goals, and timelines. They anticipate the deadlines and data needed, help with continuing reviews and any FDA updates, professional meeting abstracts, helps with sponsor audits, help review previous publications and reports, helps with data tables, charts, graphs, and scan images, and also mentor other research nurses. Research nurse coordinators multitask, So here is the day in the life of a research coordinator that you may see. You may see them at inpatient rounds. You see them at the clinic, follow-ups with participants, with the principal investigators and with sponsors, provide phone calls, screening participants, data management activities, and assisting with the monitoring and audit visits. Roles based on different responsibilities within the research team. You have the clinical research nurse coordinator and the research nurse coordinator, and both helps with clinical practice, human subjects protection, contribution to the science, care coordination and continuity of care, and study management. And as you can see, both roles do the same thing, but they have different responsibilities and the weight of each role may differ. The protocol coordinator workload may include protocol development, such as assistance with writing and developing new protocols for new and established investigators, guiding and mentoring new investigators. Data entry may assist with entry of current and historical data, potential for trend analysis, and potential new information for future studies. Protocol coordination helps with the screening, recruiting, CRIS coordination, and providing institutional knowledge, regulatory support with help with IRB submissions, including continued reviews, initial review of the study and amendments, and resource for regulatory updates. In 2018, American Nurses Association, ANA, recognized clinical research nursing as a specialty nursing practice. Our success is determined by the quality of services we provide to others and to ourselves. Quality is the result of an excellent work culture, open and effective communication, and learning from one another with constructive feedback. Here are some questions. Number one, you have to be certified in research in order to be a research nurse coordinator. False. You do not have to be certified in research in order to be a research nurse coordinator. Number two, research nurses only work at hospitals. False. Research nurses have a variety of roles and they do not only work at hospitals. Number three, research nursing is not recognized as a subspecialty. False. Research nurse is now recognized as a subspecialty. Thank you so much for listening. Hope you have a great day.